Welcome to the new video. Today we'll be discussing about how to connect the HMI with the schematic PLC. So you'll be learning the on and off control and the analog control in the HMI and the PLC. After configuring the PLC stuff, we have to go to add a new device, that will be my HMI. So we'll be using the basic panel of 9-inch display, using a normal basic panel, double tap, and that has been ready to go. And go for the PLC connection first. I have to select the PLC. From here I am using the 317 PLC, and that will be interfaced through the PROFINET. And the screen layout I'm not using right now. The alarms, everything in the default mode. The screen, if you want to add a new screen, you can add from here. And next, the system screens, if you don't need any system screens, you can uncheck all this stuff. Go for the buttons, everything will be in the default mode. So hit the finish button. So we just configured our HMI screen, and we have to check for the communication first. Go for the PLC hardware device view and go for the network view. You can see both of them are connected to the industrial Ethernet or the PROFINET. So you can go for the topology view. If you don't have any connection, you can do it manually by clicking and dragging through the PROFINET. And you can close this and you go to right to the OB one and create a program. So I'm using a digital one. First in an input and output, that will be M0.0, that will be the first input, and this will be Q0.0, that will be the output, first input and output for the digital on and off control for the HMI. And I'm using another thing, that will be M0.1 for the starting the addition block. I'm just using the basic instruction addition block right here, and that will be an integer, and MW2 will be added to MW2 itself. So that will be going in an incremental order by 1. So when the switch is on, the MW2 will be added with 1 and stores in MW2 itself. So that will be an incremental order. So MW2 will be my address for the HMI, and I can go for the HMI to create new screen. Go for the root screen. This is my root screen, and I'm deleting these steps, and I'm going to add one thing, that will be button. That button will be an on and off button. And again, duplicate two buttons, one for switching on the light and one for triggering the incremental block. So just go for right click and go for the properties. In the general, I'm using the tag right here. In the PLC tag, before tag table, you can see the M0.0, that will be the trigger to turn on the light. So go for the properties of light and go to the animations and dynamics, colors and flashing. You can go and select your appropriate tag. That will be Q0.0. That Q0.0 will be your tag, and the IO range will be, the type will be in range, and 0 and 1 will be the range. And I can choose the colors at the 0, that will be on red, at 1 that will be green. So I'm making it red and green for its conditions as 0 and 1. And I can choose one more thing. From here I can trigger my incremental block, and I can watch the values through an IO field right here. I'm using an IO field. So right click and properties, go to the properties, and in general I can add up the tag right here. Normal PLC tag, that will be MW2. In MW2, I'm saving the incremental tag. And if you want to watch it like as a trend, I can use a trend view also. I can reduce the size of the trend view and place it right here. So that's it. That's the trend view. and here you can watch the trends. Notice I'm using just a 9-inch panel, so the space would be a little bit lesser for this. If you want to practice in a bigger one, you can choose a 15-inch panel. That will be much easier for you to program from the basics. So increasing the length and width and go for the trend and go for the trend and adding a new trend from the source, that will be from the PLC tag, that will be MW2, that will be showing the trend and cyclically real time and trend view. That's it. So we can simply first go for running the program OB1. I'm going to start the simulation. So I'm going to load this. So the PLC program has been loaded and we are going to online mode. Now we are at online mode and I'm going to run the controller first. So the controller is in runtime and I can minimize the simulation window. I can go for the HMI. So inside the HMI screen, I can go for selecting the root screen and go to the simulation. After compiling, that simulation will be appearing soon. You can see this is my simulation window, will be starting soon. So this is my simulation window and you can see my trend is at zero, and when I turn on the switch M0.0, that will be triggered by the light. And if you do want to watch this in my PLC screen, I can show you that also. Go for the OB1 and you can see M0.0 will be on and off depending upon the HMI screen. And clicking it on and off, you can see that's it. So you can, if you want to increment the tag, you can use this thing and that will be incrementing in one by one in every milliseconds. You can see here M0.1, that will be triggering soon. I just created a wrong connection, so I can go for the HMI screen once again. For this I'm using go for the properties and general. I didn't configure any tag, so I can use the M0.1 tag. You simply hit it and go to the simulation once again. So that will be very easy to troubleshoot because I am using the PROFINET. That will be very fast and much very responsive also. And here we go again, and if you try to switch it on again, you can see the tag will be incrementing and the value of the thing or the trend will be, we cannot adjust. And if you want change it, I can go for the auto ranging also. By closing this, I can go for the properties of the trend and the high and lower ends text format root table and right value axis, and you can make it as x and y auto sizing, auto ranging. I can choose the x y axis and the x axis. Left value axis I can use as auto ranging. Both of them I have changed as an auto ranging thing. And you can, if you go to the runtime again, see that will be auto ranging during the incremental tag. So that's the trend view, and hope you understand this video. Thank you.